with the following figure. This was the figure 14 question. A, B, C. AB equal to AC. Okay. First part we have already proved. B is the angle bisector. And F. Okay, we have to prove ED this length. ED is equal to EF. This you have to prove. So how you are going to prove?
Sir, first we proved that this is a congruent triangle by AAS.
These two triangles are congruent. First you have to prove these two triangles are congruent. Okay. So take the triangle we are taking BD. Okay, that day we take first this one. Okay, BFE and triangle BFE BDE. Okay, now prove them to be congruent. So it is given BE is angle bisector. It is bisecting angle B. Therefore, this angle equal to this angle. Angle FBE. FBE equal to angle DBE. Okay, because BE is bisector of angle ABC. Okay, this is the reason it is bisector of angle ABC.
Sir, how is the bisector of ABC?
Read the question. What is given last line? BE bisects angle B. It is given. BE bisects angle B.
It only bisects angle E, not to angle C.
Again ask.
So now understand.
Understood. BE bisects angle B. This angle it is bisecting. Therefore, these two angles are equal. These two are already given. They are 90 degrees. It is given. EF is perpendicular to AB. EF perpendicular to AB. This already given altitude. So angle BFE equal to angle BDE, because ED is perpendicular to BD and EF perpendicular to EB. You can write AB as well, you can write, doesn't matter it. So FB I am writing. Okay, you can write AD perpendicular to BC as well, the reason. And EF perpendicular to AB as well, you can write. Okay. Now, best one, two, third. One more we require. BE equal to BE. So, by AAS theorem. Okay, these two triangles are congruent. If these two triangles are congruent, it means corresponding parts will be congruent as well. It means opposite to this angle, this side, opposite to this angle, this side. These two sides are as well equal. So ED equal to EF. CPCPC. Understood now? Have you understood?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Now try 15th one, everyone. Yes.
Sir, I am facing problem in naming the triangles.
Okay, naming the triangles, let's see in 15th, okay? We'll see in 15th again how to name the triangles, okay? If any trouble arises, you can name according as per your need, okay? You can name BFE, EDEV. No issues with that, okay? If you are not able to figure out how to name them, you can go with any name, okay? Either BFE and second angle EDB. No issues with that, okay? Okay, in 15th, we'll see how to name it properly, okay? Okay, use the information to give figure to prove. First, draw the figure. Okay. And now onwards, we'll see how to name each figure. Okay. So first, the figure is given. These two lines are parallel. It is given. A, B, C, D, E, F. Okay. Okay, we have to prove. Yes, okay. This you have to prove. First, you can switch off your camera. This is clear. This you have to prove. AB equal to FE, it means AB equal to FE. Second, BD equal to CF. BD equal to CF. These two things you have to prove, okay? Now see your first one. How, which triangles you have to take? First, you have to figure out that. Okay, here two triangles are given, so it's easy to figure out. Which two triangles you have to prove to be congruent? This triangle and this triangle, okay? Now, how to take the name, okay? So, triangle, okay. Which you are, okay, for example, we are taking. This is first triangle, this is second triangle, okay? Now, see, if you are naming it as ABC, okay? Triangle ABC we are taking. Second triangle. Now see here, it's a kind of, we know which vertex will be corresponding vertex to the other, okay? Okay, see here, angle A. A vertex seems to be same as E, B, same as F, D and C. You can see this angle is equal to this angle. So these two vertex, they must be corresponding. See, it means wherever C is at the third position, so D must come as at the third position, okay? Now, these two, okay? You can see as well, this line is equal to this line. It means angle opposite to this one, B. Angle opposite to this one, F. B and F are the corresponding ones. B, so F will come here in the second position, okay? Now remaining A and E. E will come here. Have you understood this one? So it's yes, a kind of, we are yes, predicting, sir. We are predicting or we are knowing that which vertices will be the corresponding vertices. Okay. It's kind of, we have already proved that they are congruent. Now we are accordingly writing them. Okay. Understood? A vertex, E. Then, okay, we started with C. C is here. This angle is equals. It means it will be equal to D. Then this side equal to this side, opposite to them, B. So second position F, remaining A, E. Okay. Now it will be very easy. So, okay. Yes.
So we can take another type also, no? Like B, yes, E, F.
B, E, F. What is that? B, E, F.
Triangle D, F.
D, E, F. Okay. If you are taking triangle D, E, F. Okay, what will be the triangle here? D corresponding to D first, C will
sir,
come.
C-A-B. C-A-B.
And E, E, A will come. Okay, and F, B will come. Okay, you can take it like this as well. It's up to you.
Okay.
Corresponding must be there, okay? If you are not able to get the corresponding one, forget about this, simply write the two triangles, okay? Is this clear? This is convention we used to follow. It's not necessary you must follow as well. But it becomes easier to solve the question as well. As well for someone to check as well, it becomes very easier. For example, you are showing to your friends. So since you have followed the same kind of rules in naming as well, so it becomes easy to understand for others as well. Okay. As well, now you easily can see. See here, corresponding to C, we have the D vertex. A, we have the E vertex. B, we have the F vertex. And see here how easily we are able to prove. Okay. Through these things only you can prove. Okay. Now, what is given? First one.
Sir, A C B equal to E D F.
Okay. Okay. Let's take the side first. Okay. AC. Okay, see here. If you are taking AC, one side you will take here AC. ED?
ED.
Okay, now see here from the naming only you can take. What you have taken? AC side, from A we are moving to C. You are moving like this. It means from the second E you will move towards this one. ED. Understood? ED. Very easily you are able to figure out from the naming as well, name as well. A, B, E, D, okay. Reason given. Okay. Now, see a second. If you are taking the angle now, okay. If you are taking A, C, D, or A, C, B, or take it B, A, C, B, C, A. Okay. A, C, B, you are taking angle A, C, B, for example, you have taken. Okay. You can as well write it as angle B, C, A. Okay, you have taken A, C, B. Now see here in the name. A, C, B. You have moved from here to here, then here. Okay, here as well. E, D, F you will move. E, D, F. From the name only you can prove. You are moving from A, C, B, D, E, D, F. You don't even require the figure now. A, C, B, D, E, F. So, A, C, B, E, D, F, E, D, F, E, D, F. They are, it's given already. Okay. Now, what about
something? A, B is equal to B.
That is.
Sir, B is equal to E, F.
This is to be proved.
No, sir. AD is equal to DE.
A, D, which angle? Again, tell. Which one?
Sir, angle EFD is equal to ABC.
No, sir. I mistake.
EFD equal to angle?
ABC.
Okay, reason?
Sir,
interior alternate. Reason?
Sir, interior
alternate. Okay. E, which angle?
Sir, angle F and angle B.
Okay, so you are saying this angle and this angle. Okay, can you see? It is a line. Okay. EF is the. So what are these two lines are? Yeah, parallel lines. And third line is cutting
the lines.
These two angles are alternate interior.
Alternate angle.
They are alternate interior angles or interior alternate angles. They are alternate interior angles. Can you see that? These two lines are parallel. Okay. See, this line is cutting these two lines. It means this angle equal to this angle. Why? These are alternate interior angles. Okay. So what we have? Okay. It means this angle equal to this angle. They are alternate interior angles. Okay. So see how we are writing. From the first time, if we are writing angle ABC. Angle ABC. Angle ABC. Here we'll write angle EFD. Angle EFD. See, from the naming only we are able to get easily them. If you are writing angle ABC, it means angle EFD. EFD. They are equal because they are alternate interior angles. Okay. reason you can write AB parallel to FE. Okay. Alternating angle since these two lines are parallel. Okay. Now, which theorem we have used? Angle, angle, side. It is AAS. So, by AAS, these two triangles are congruent. Write the triangle's name here. Triangle ABC. Triangle EFD. So, see here, by naming, it becomes very easy to figure out. AC, yeah. So, it means DE. AC, ED. ACD, ACD. EDF. ABC, ABC. It means EFD. ABC, okay, angle A, okay. Angle ABC, 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 okay, so name like this, and you can see your form here, so ABC, ABC, angle AC, ACD, angle EDF. The name of the figure you can get them easily. Okay.
So your voice is not coming clear.
Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Whenever sir, it's not clear, just let me know. Yes.
Sir, in third point, you written alternate interior angles. AB is parallel to FE. FE is EF not come.
I have written AB, therefore I have put FE. If you are writing B, okay, what is given question? Okay, nothing is given, so it's up to you. Okay, see here, here it's necessary. Here you can write, here mainly I write BA, it means that direction EF. Okay, ABFE, ABFE, this direction I have written. Okay, you can write it as well, like this BA. Parallel to EF. Okay.
Okay, sir.
BA parallel to EF. Okay. I used to follow the same direction. And so you can write AB parallel to EF. No issue with that. But I usually follow the same directions if they are moving this, this direction. This is clear. Okay. So what we have proved? What can be proved now? These two triangles are congruent. As these two triangles are congruent, AB equal to FE. AB equal to FE. Reason CPCTC. Reason CPCTC. Okay. So I'm rubbing this part. Second part, how to prove. Okay. AB equal to FE, we have already proved through CPCTC. Okay. BD equal to CF, how to prove. This we have already proved. Okay, so we have to prove BD equal to CF. It means this length from B to D is equal to C to F. These two are equal. How to prove? Okay, we have already proved these two triangles are congruent. It means BC equal to FD. BC equal to FD. This you already proved. How we have proved? CPCTC. Through CPCTC, these two are as well equal. This is the side of this triangle, BD, BC, and this is the triangle, this triangle side, FD. These two are equal by CPCTC. Okay, now if we subtract CD, it is common for both the sides. It is common for both the triangles, this length. If we subtract the same length from both, the equality holds. So if I write BC minus DC equal to FD minus CD. CD, DC, they are same only. Okay. BC minus DC. How much it will be? BD FD minus CD. It will be CF. Hence, proved. Understood?
Yes, sir.
So from the sides, we are separating the same quantity. Same quantity we are separating. So equality holds and BD equal to CF. There will be many questions over these. Okay. So it's common for both. Common thing, common part we are separating from both them, of both of them. Okay. 15th question is clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now sir. Let's start. 9th B exercise, first question. Try that one. 9th B, first question. 9th A, anyone about? And we along with see the naming of the triangles, okay? Yes.
Well, I haven't written that.
Yes, Siddhi, what are you asking?
So you rub the board and I haven't written that also.
Okay, just 1 minute. By the way, you can write it yourself now or not. So BC equal to FD. What was the reason?
CPCDC.
By because since these two triangles are congruent, it means opposite to this side, opposite to this side. BC equal to FD. Okay. Now from both the side, we are separating the equal quantity CD. Okay. Same thing we are separating, so equality holds. BC equal to FD minus CD, or you can write DC. From both the side, we are separating DC. This length we are separating. Okay. BC minus CD is what? BD. Okay. And from this, we are separating CD again. So what is this length? CF. Okay. Hence proof. Clear now?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. 9th B, we can start. So everyone have written these all? Okay. After?
Yes, sir.
Practice without looking in the book or notebook, okay? Just write the question and try to practice them yourself. That's the best way to learn. Okay. Read the first question. On the sides AB and AC of a triangle ABC, equilateral triangles ABD and ACE are drawn. Okay, so we are having a triangle and on its side, two sides we are making triangles. Equilateral triangles means
all the sides are equal.
All the three angles of the triangle will be equal.
So your voice is not clear.
Is it fine now?
Sir.
Okay. So we are divided with one triangle. For example, this is the triangle. Okay. The triangle like this.
Not clear.
Is it fine now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it is provided. We have, okay, see here. On the sides AB and AC of triangle ABC. So we have a triangle ABC. This is our triangle ABC. And on the sides AB and AC of the triangle, equilateral triangles are drawn. on the sides AB and AC of a triangle, two equilateral triangles are drawn. That means one equilateral triangle is drawn here. Okay, it means equilateral means these are equal sides. Okay, and ABD. Similarly, an equilateral triangle is drawn here. Okay, these are equal. ACE. Okay, AC are drawn. Have you understood this one? It's like cat ears. One ear is smaller than the other, maybe. Okay. Now prove that angle CAD. We have to prove angle CAD. I'm marking with red now. Angle CAD. CAD. This angle. Is equal to angle BAE. BAE equal to angle this angle. We have to prove these two angles are equal. Have you understood it? So angle CAD equal to angle BAE. This angle equal to this angle. Okay. This red one we have to prove. Okay. So how we are going to prove? This angle equal to this angle. The middle part is common to both. See here. This angle plus this. This angle plus this. We are adding the same quantity. So if we prove this angle equal to this angle, we can easily prove these two are equal. Yes or no? You can see if you take this angle, okay? If you are taking this angle only, you can see this plus this. Angle DAB plus angle BAC. Angle BAC. Okay, similarly take this angle. Angle EAC plus angle BAC again. So we are adding the same quantity. Or if we prove this angle equal to this angle, it means the bigger red ones, we can easily prove they are equal. So how to prove these two are equal? This one and this one. How to prove?
So we can take two triangles ADB and AEC.
Okay, we have taken them.
Then we can prove the equal sides of all of the triangle.
These sides are already equal. It is given. Yeah. These three sides are already equal. Yes, please mute yourself. I can easily say who of the there.
So we can take the two triangles and by CPCT, see, we can prove.
How you can prove that these two triangles are congruent? These are similar for sure, but there's no way we can prove these two triangles are congruent. These are similar because both are equilateral triangles. Both are equilateral triangles. So what about the angles?
Sir, all the angles are equal.
All, okay. This is equilateral triangle. So all the angles are 60 degrees. This angle will be how much? This angle, 60 degrees.
Yes,
this
sir.
Angle is 60 degrees. As well, this is equilateral triangle. This angle is how much?
60 degrees.
Okay, we have proved. Okay, mute yourself once. See here. 60 degree plus angle BAC. 60 degree plus angle BAC. Equal? Okay. So, how we have proved? Angle. Okay. We have to prove this one. So, angle DAB equal to how much? 60 degree equal to 60 degree. This is clear because triangle DAB you can name. DAB is an, okay, what is given by the way? ABD. So triangle ABD we can take. Triangle ABD is an equilateral lateral triangle. It's an equilateral triangle. It means all the three angles are equal, 60 degree. Sides are equal. It means angles opposite to them are as well equal. Okay, this is clear. Second in this triangle, angle EAC equal to 60 degree. Again, triangle is an equilateral triangle. Okay, this is clear. This is 60 degree. This is 60 degree. Okay, now what is angle DAC? Angle DAC equal to angle DAC equal to angle DAB plus angle BAC. Is it clear? Angle DAC, angle DAC equal to angle DAB plus this angle plus this angle. Okay. What is angle DAB? 60 degree. So angle DAC equal to 60 degree plus angle BAC. This is clear. We have got angle DAC, 60 degree plus angle BAC. Okay, similarly do with this one. BAE we have to prove. BAE. Okay, angle BAE equal to angle EAC, EAC plus angle BAC we can write, or you can write CAB. It's same, so I'm writing BAC. Okay, so this angle BAE equal to angle BAC plus EAC. That only we have written. Angle EAC is 60 degree. 60 degree plus angle BAE. This is first, this is second. You can say 60 plus angle BAC. 60 degree plus
angle BAE.
BAC. Okay. So you can see these are equal. It means these are equal. So from first and second. So from first and second, angle BAC equal to angle BAE. We have proved. Have you understood this one? 60 degree plus BAC. 60 degree plus BAC. So common is BAC. In both triangles, common is 60 plus BAC, 60 plus BAC. Therefore, these two angles are equal. Therefore, these two angles are equal. Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Again, explain it.
Okay. See here. Take this angle. What angle we have to prove? Angle CAD. CAD we have to prove. Okay, you can write CAD there. Instead of DAC, you can write CAD. CAD. Okay. See it again. We have to prove angle C. Okay. What we have proved first? This is 60 degree in this triangle. This angle will be 60 degree or not? This angle, this 60, 60, 60. It's an equilateral triangle. Therefore, this angle could be 60 degree. As well in this angle will be 60 degree. This angle. Equilateral triangle. Okay. Now, first we are taking CAD. CAD angle equal to CAD. This angle. This whole red marked angle. Equal to angle DAB plus BAC angle. Angle BAC. This angle plus this angle. So 60 plus angle BAC. Understood this one? Angle CAD equal to 60 plus angle BAC. Okay. Now, take this one. Angle BAE. This one. It will be how much? Again, 60 degree plus angle BAC. It means in both the angles, what is common? Angle BAC. Angle CAD equal to 60 degree plus angle BAC. Angle BA equal to 60 degree plus angle BAC. You can see 60 plus angle BAC. 60 plus angle BAC. It means CAD is equal to BAE. It means CAD angle equal to BAE angle. Have you understood it now?
Yes, sir.
In both of them, we are having 60 plus this common part. 60 plus this common angle. Okay. Second part we'll do tomorrow. Okay. So to make CD equal to. In second part, we have to prove. Okay, this has straight lines. Okay. This equal to this. It means we have to prove these two triangles are congruent. That we'll do tomorrow. We'll draw these two triangles separately and we'll prove. Yes.
Sir, I have doubt in first step.
Yes. Tell the page number.
So page number 23.
Page number 23. Yes, which question?
So question number 3, 6 to n, 6 and 9.
Question number 3, 6 and?
And 9.
Okay, 3 is rational. Okay, I will give you the idea now. After we have one more period, okay? We'll discuss them in detail. Rationalize the denominators of, only the denominator is here, is irrational?
So that see the I first, understand. But
okay.
So I got the answer at last, sir, but cutting system I not understand, cutting method.
Okay, so let's do one thing. We are having one more period, 12:32:1.
Yes, sir.
Okay. In that we'll discuss, okay? So 10 sir. Minutes earlier we will start and after the words we can take any amount of time, okay? So 20 minutes we'll carry this question and after that 10 minutes we'll take these doubts. If we require more time we can take, okay? Because after one, we don't have any more classes, okay? So do remind me in that period, okay? After 20 minutes, first we'll discuss that question and we'll start discussing this, okay?
Okay.
Okay, thank you all.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
If you have the doubts, be there in the last period. If you have the doubts, be there. You have to be there in class, last period, because we are going to discuss the question as well, okay?
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
And whatever doubts you have, we have a lot of time after 1 p.m. So don't worry and stay here. We'll discuss. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.